Hello, 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 everyone. God bless you. I just wanted to share a quick word with you on today. I'm simply going to be talking about prayer. And if I was going to put a title to what I'm talking about today, it would be called The Prayer Manual. Because I'm basically going to go through the Lord's Prayer and we're going to talk about how to effectively pray. I've mentioned it before that sometimes we can say, pray, pray, pray. We can encourage people to pray, but it can become very frustrating when a person doesn't understand how to pray. So here we're going to take a closer look at the Lord's Prayer and really examine the example that Jesus Christ gave us when he was teaching his disciples. So the Lord's Prayer is found in Matthew chapter 6, and it begins in verse 9. And he says to his disciples, after this manner, therefore pray ye, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen, amen, and amen. So I just want to break that down verse by verse. And so here we have number one. So I would say there's six steps. There's six points on how we pray. Number one, in verse one, he says, Our Father, whom art in heaven. And just right at the very beginning, he calls God Father. He acknowledges God as Father. Therefore, letting you know that there's a relationship, that it's not overly formal, but there is obviously a trust relationship there. And the word father, one of the definitions of father is source or originator of. So that lets you know, hey, God, I am not just, you know, saying that you're some mystical figure. You are my father. You are my source. I have come from you. I have your DNA. That is so powerful. It's such a sense of belonging, you know, and some of us, we may not have parents, but we can acknowledge God as our Father, and there's a sense of belonging there. He goes on to say, whom art in heaven? He's acknowledging that God is up high, that he is not of this world. You know, he is placed high and lifted up. He is in heaven. So he's acknowledging God's position. He's acknowledging the throne of God. In verse 2, it says, hallowed be your name. So where do we go after that? After we have acknowledged our relationship with God, after we have acknowledged the fact that we belong to him and that he is high above us, high above our ways, then we go into a place of worship. And he says, hallowed be your name. So right there, before we ask for anything, when we're going to God in prayer, it's important for us to worship him, to adore him, to begin to speak well of him. You know, just like a parent, if you need something from a parent, one of the better things to do is potentially sweet them up with some nice words. Oh, mommy or daddy, I love you. Or, oh, you're my hero. Something like that. Just to show the Lord your appreciation. In verse 3, then he goes on to say, your kingdom come, your will be done. Right here, what's happening is Jesus is showing his disciples how to come into alignment with the will of the Father, saying, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So God, we say, we surrender. Okay, so we're stepping into the place of surrender, of where his will is now more important than our will, where we surrender our thoughts for his thoughts, where we lay down our will for his will. This is very important in prayer. The next verse, he talks and he says to the Lord, give us this day our daily bread. And a lot of the times people might think that that just means, oh, I need to read my word. Obviously, that's very important. But I just got to check in my spirit that what Jesus was saying is that we need to endeavor to not just have the word of God, but a word from God, the prophetic word. And that's what's so beautiful about prayer is that it's conversation. It's not so much just about what we are saying to God, but what is God saying to us? And what he is saying to us is the daily bread. It is the now word. It is the manna. You can't save manna from a previous day to the next day. It goes bad. So likewise, we are supposed to be getting a daily word, a daily revelation from the Father. Daily, we're supposed to hear what thus saith the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Then he goes on to say, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. It's very important. Anytime you're going before the Father, the reality is we are mere flesh. So it is possible for us to sin and sometimes not even know. So to cover all our bases, I suggest that anytime you go to God in prayer, cover yourself with repentance and humility, because we're not perfect. So we always need the grace of God and the blood of Jesus to purify us and wash us, because of our own righteousness is filthy rags, the word of the Lord declares. So always you want to make sure that you have a repentant heart as well when you approach the Father. And then to close it off again, he goes into worship declarations. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. And that's very important as well, because we need to understand that when we're praying, we're not just asking for things all the time, but we are making powerful declarations. We are stating who our God is and who he is in the earth and what he can do in our lives. Yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. This is just the acknowledgement of the lordship of Christ. So I just want to encourage you as you're going forward in your prayer walk with God, remember these steps: worship, remember acknowledgement, remember alignment and surrender, remember prophetic insight that this is your daily bread, so seek to have dialogue with the Father. Remember to go in with a heart of repentance and a heart of forgiveness. It's not enough for him to forgive us, but we also have to forgive those who sin against us. And also, don't forget your worship declarations. As you decree a thing in the earth, it shall be established. And I just want to say God bless you, and I encourage you to go back over this scripture and pray. Go back over and say, Lord, teach me further how to pray, and let the Lord give you revelation on how to truly connect with him and how to hear from him. God bless you.